with this lockdown, since it happened, what are the some of the things that you now feel like you've been taking for granted, or some of the things that you just simply miss, or ikumbula ukuzenza on a daily?
Nothing really. Nothing has really changed for me. I still wake up at 3:30 in the morning. I still go in the morning. I'm still in the office as we speak right now.
Yes. So
my life hasn't changed that much, you know. Except for the fact that when I get to the office, there's like 3 people.
Taking it back to the day when we didn't have the internet and we didn't have the kind of cell phones we have, if you had to think about if we had to have gone through this 21 lockdown then, how hard would it have been for us?
I think it would have been impossible. I can't imagine what we would have done with ourselves. I suppose we would have had to talk to each other or something.
Right. Right. So congratulations on the deal with Def Jam. Please tell me when you got the news. Ufile kanjani if it's at that point?
Well, for me, the news didn't hit me all at once. It came in waves, because first it was, oh, Def Jam is interested in you. They see what you're doing. Oh, snap. Now they want to do dinner. Oh, snap. Now they want to be in studio with me just to listen to the songs. Now they want to give me tickets to this show just so I can come have fun and be in the area a bit more. And then we sealed the deal. Like, we took a bit of time just to feel each other out, see if this thing can work, and try and see what opportunities we have, you know, to go tell the African narrative there in the States as a person who comes directly from it and put it on, you know. And we found that gap. We realized that there is a spot there. And it's always been my goal to break in the States also. So it just came at the perfect time, you know. It just came in different stages, different phases.
How much do you think we're actually going to suffer? Is it actually just going to be 21 days? Because I think that's the biggest question that we all have now. But I mean, you used to waking up at 5 in the morning, reading scripts and all of that. And how do you think our industry is suffering at this point in time?
I think it's going to hit us hard. A lot of our industry is dependent on freelancers, meaning no work, no pay.
Yes.
And in that respect, that means a lot of us are going to take a knock. That means a lot of jobs that are going to be lost. Because when we come back, it's going to be, you know, essential people only. And they're going to do away with anybody who's not really essential. And we work with big teams, you know. Every single production works with at least 60 to 70 people. There's a lot of people on every production. So we've got to keep that in mind, that it's a lot of people at stake.